Hey guys, I just got back from an incredible weekend of riding down in southern Utah on the new Santa Cruz 5010. This is a total party bike. It's so much fun. It does everything well. It is like the quintessential trail bike with 27.5 wheel size wheels. Did I say that right? Which was a lot of fun because I spend so much time on 29ers. The whole industry is just full gas 29ers. So when I do get a chance to get back on a 27.5 wheel size bike, like the 5010 here, it's super duper fun and it's just a party the whole time. I ride my wife's Ibis Mojo 4 from time to time, which is a lot of fun. This kind of reminds me of that in some ways. And it also kind of reminds me of the Yeti SB140 in some ways. Stick around to the end of the video and I'll kind of talk more about how this bike compares to other ones. But real quick, let's talk about who today's video sponsor is. It's Velocirax. Velocirax is a new emerging bike rack. That's a hitch mount bike rack and it holds up to 7 bikes, which is pretty uncommon on bike racks. Most of them hold like 2 to 4. So if you have to haul around more than 4 bikes at a time, Velocirax is truly like the best in the business. I've used so many other hitch mount upright bike racks and Velocirax has them all beat. They sent me one about 2 months ago and I've been using it now on 3 trips down to southern Utah and then just running about the neighborhoods here. Everything about it is user-friendly, easy to load bikes, holds lots of bikes, and I cannot be more stoked on a bike rack right now than that. Full review on the bike rack coming soon, but they're today's actual video sponsor. So thank you to Velocirax. There's a link below to go over and learn more about Velocirax and how you can order and just get more information about this new emerging brand of bike rack. Onto the 5010. Let's talk about how it climbs and how it descends. Climbing is really good. Like I would say in the category, it's gotta be one of the better climbers. Not in like just pedal efficiency, like how smooth it goes along the trail, but in actual technical terrain, rocky stuff. Down in southern Utah, we have a lot of this like shelfy kind of rocks, of kind of these shelfy rock sections that are pretty technical climbs. And the 5010 just gets right up all of it, just finds the traction and gets up. It's really actually really good. You know, maybe it doesn't have quite as efficient pedaling feeling just on flat terrain. Maybe the Ibis Mojo 4 might eke it out just a little bit right there. But the bike's geometry has you in a really aggressive like pedaling position. It's got almost a 77 degree seat tube angle, 65.5 degree head tube angle. And it kind of varies between each sizing in the Santa Cruz 5010 lineup. So on a medium that I'm on is gonna be a different, slightly different than a large or an extra large, right? And the same thing's true with the chainstays on the 5010. And like this is where Santa Cruz kind of has like the future of bikes figured out. Like what's next for bikes? I think it's, you know, different bits on the geometry are gonna be different between a medium, a large, and an extra large, or even a small. Click the link down below in the description to the 5010 where you can click on the geometry because it's not exactly 65.5 degrees and not exactly 77 degrees on the seat tube angle, but it's really close. And there's a high and a low setting. I rode it in the low setting the entire time. No pedal strikes, by the way. I know that's a question I get a lot when I do my reviews is if I get pedal strikes on this bike and I didn't get any. You feel really out up over the bars and this, you know, where reach used to be a really big deal on bikes. Like I used to own a 2016 Santa Cruz 5010. The reach doesn't feel that long on this size medium bike. I'm 5'8" on a medium bike and you just feel like right over the bars in the climbing position because of how steep that seat tube angle is, right? But yeah, click that link down below and you can kind of look at all the different geometry numbers and everything. It comes in 2 colors, this kind of green color and then a kind of a burgundy red color. Gunthery Bike Shop in Salt Lake City has both these colors in stock in every single size. So if you're looking for a 5010, reach out to Preston at Gunthery's Bikes in Salt Lake City. They let me borrow the bike for this video. In fact, I've had it for a couple weeks now and just been enjoying it, riding it, rode it down in St. George, been riding it up here in Salt Lake. And anyway, check them out. I have a link to their shop as well. Excellent shop to work with. They carry Pivot, Trek, and Santa Cruz, I think, but they've got 5010s in stock. This is the part of the video I wanted to talk most about, which is descending. This is like the perfect trail bike. It climbs, you know, good enough. You know, I don't think you'd get overly fatigued on a long day of riding or you know, going on a 30-mile ride. It climbs great, but it descends exceptionally well for a 27.5 wheel size bike with 130 millimeters of travel in the rear and 140 millimeters travel in the front. It just does great everywhere. Descending, it feels almost bottomless. Like, it would take a lot of really chundery trail to find the limits of this bike. That's why I think it's such a neat trail bike. It can kind of do everything. Because it's on a smaller wheel size platform on the 27.5 instead of the 29er, I think it maybe leans more toward people who are shorter, like myself. If you're a size medium or a size small, that's kind of who the wheel size is for. Because, you know, after a couple days of riding it, I did think to myself, okay, you know, when I'm going to do this review, I'm going to have to address the elephant in the room, which is, why not just get the Santa Cruz Tallboy? The Tallboy has 120 millimeters of travel in the rear, 130 in the front. Very similar geometry. I think it's only a degree slacker in the rear. And then the entire wheelbase on a size medium, the Tallboy is little less than an inch longer. So it's a slightly longer wheelbase, but the Tallboy is still a very sporty trail bike. So I think for most people, it would really have to come down to the wheel size between getting this or the Tallboy. This might feel a little smoother in some sections on the descents than the Tallboy, just a little bit here and there. But overall, I would say that's really a toss-up of which wheel size you prefer between the 29er or the 27.5. This might feel a little more sporty. I didn't get a chance to ride them back-to-back, but I have ridden the current generation Tallboy a number of times, and I really enjoy that bike, and I find it to be probably the best bike in the Santa Cruz lineup in terms of do everything trail bike. And so I just think this might be slightly more playful and more maneuverable because of the wheel size, but overall it is very similar to that Tallboy, and the Tallboy benefits from that rollover because of the larger wheel. I hate to belabor the topic of the wheel size so much, but it really is a real issue. For shorter riders, the smaller 27.5 wheel size is really welcome in chunkier, steeper terrain. On steeper terrain where you're really getting off the back of the bike, that 29-inch wheel will buzz your butt. And it's like the most frustrating thing. And sometimes it's like a real bad situation, but not all the time, but you're aware of it. Taller riders with longer legs, I don't think they have that issue. So a 27.5 wheel size bike is nice in the steeper terrain for shorter riders because it's not an issue. You know, you have so much more, you have a bit more space. So it's super helpful in those situations. I think this bike might be a little bit more sporty and maneuverable than the Tallboy, but not so much so. I would say if you're really considering the 5010 and you have a chance to demo both the 5010 and the Tallboy, you really owe it to yourself to ride both bikes back to back. You might be surprised at how sporty Tallboy is for a 29-inch trail bike. And the geometry is not that different between the two bikes, really. I think I've talked on all the things I wanted to talk about. Now, like, I want to talk about who the bike was for and really how it compares to, like, the Yeti SB140 and the Ibis Mojo 4, which are kind of similar bikes in a similar category. I would tell you that the Tallboy is probably the most well-rounded of the bunch. It just descends so well. It descends as well as the Yeti SB140, but it has a more playful characteristic. The SB140 just has this like go straight fast type of situation, which is it's got that its place in the world. But for me, I want to have a lot of fun on bikes. This has more sporty a more sporty feel to it. It's more maneuverable and you know, it still descends incredibly well. The Ibis Mojo 4, I think, is trying to keep up with the other two bikes on the downhill, but it's the most lively, sporty of the bunch. And I think the Tallboy, or excuse me, the 5010 just kind of sits in, nestles right there in the middle. And so I really do think this is probably, if you want a 27.5 wheel size bike, this is probably the, like I said at the beginning of the video, the do everything trail bike. It's just really, really good. And the rear suspension on Santa Cruz bikes is just so good. It's so good. It's like magic. It's bottomless. It's very damp and supportive feeling and easy to set up. And the RockShox suspension today was awesome to ride and all last weekend when I was down in St. George. So What a cool package. Thanks to Guns Rebikes for letting me borrow this bike. If you have any questions or comments, put it in the description down below. The 5010 is different than what it was in 2016 when I owned it. I would say that it has a lot more Bronson brought into the 5010 now, which I think is a good thing. It's a more capable bike. The geometry is just more forgiving, a little easier to ride. I would say that this bike is easier to ride than the previous generation 5010, which is more precise bike. And this is probably a little bit more forgiving bike. And it's a lot of fun. Yeah, I think a lot of people are gonna like this bike, especially people on size small and size medium bikes. Anyway, hope this video was helpful. We'll see you in the next one. We'll see you later, guys.
This is the time in the video when Jason turns the camera off so we can ridicule and make fun of him for the next time.
Yeah, that sounds about right. Ah, next trip. I gotta land that drop like way smoother and way faster.